art class. So now we are going to have a look at what does it mean by state and what does it mean by process. So if you have a look at the definition over here, it states that state is a condition of a system as described by its properties. A change in any of the properties will cause a change of the states. So in previous video, you already know what does it mean by intensive and extensive properties. Some of the properties is like pressure, temperature, or a mass. So now, imagine that we have a glass of water. So, and it is filled up with a water at a temperature of, let's say, 50 degrees C. Alright? And then after some times, this water, with the same mass, but the temperature have changed, equilibrium with the surroundings. Let's say your room temperature is about 30 degrees C. So now, this is what it meant by state. So at first, you have 50 degrees C, which is indicate as state 1. And when the water cool down and the temperature is about the same with your surroundings, it's going to be state 2. So now let's have a look at what does it mean by process. It says here, any action that change from one state of a system to another, so are the properties. So when any of the properties of a system change, the state also is going to change. So common process that we have here is expansion, heating, compression, and cooling. So let's have a look at the same example in here. Let me erase it first. Let's say you have a water, right? A water, and this time this water, this time the temperature of the water, let's say, is about 30 degrees C, right? And then what you do is you have a candle down here and you heat up the water until about 100 degrees C. So now, this is what we call as a process, right? Heating up over here. So the initial state of the water indicate as T1, which is 30 degrees C, and then when you heat up, which is the process, now the state becoming T2 equal to 100 degrees C. So this is what it meant by state, where you have the initial and the final. And what caused the water to raise up to 100 degrees C? Because the process of heating up over here. Alright, next we have what does it mean by the term cycle. So if you read here, it says that a series of connected processes that begins and ends at the same state. So we have a PV diagram over here, which later in a later chapter, we are going to have a look what does it mean by PV diagram. So it's, as you can see here, There are two processes. One is process A and another one is process B. Alright, now imagine that we have a piston. Alright. And this is the limit. Okay, let's say you are pushing this piston from A and then to B. So now this piston is going to be, let's say, here. So this process of A to B is going to be one process. And if we can retract this piston back to its place, right? So if we retract this back to its place, it's going to be back here. So this process from B to A can be considered as another process. So let's say A to B is number one and B to A is number two. So if it can be represented in this diagram, so you can see that it's going to be one closed cycle, provided it begins and ends at the same state. So again, I repeat, we have state A and then you push this piston forward until state B. Now it becomes one process. And then you pull back this piston from B to A. Now it becomes second process. But since it started and end and started and end at the same state, so it makes one complete cycle, like what we have in this diagram over here.